Hi there, and welcome to North Point Kids. If it's your first time here, welcome. If you've had a birthday this week, a big happy birthday. The lesson for today is about fruits. But if you're thinking apples and bananas and oranges, you're not thinking the right thing. We're learning about different special kinds of fruits. But for now, let's go jump into worship. So just close your eyes and pray with me. Father, thank you for bringing us together, Lord. Even though we can't come in person, we can still watch over YouTube and other things, Lord, to come and learn about you and to worship you. I pray that you'll fill our hearts with joy as we sing and we just celebrate you. In Jesus' name, amen.
Our God is a great big God. Our God is a great big God. Our God is a great big God, and he holds us in his hand.
Jesus, there is none more beautiful than Jesus. Fire. Lord, remind me I'm wonderfully made. You're an artist and a potter. I'm the canvas and the clay, and I know nothing has been wasted, no failure or mistake. You're an artist and a potter. I'm the canvas and the clay, and you make all things work together for my future and for my good. You make all things work together for your glory and for.
Guys had a great time in worship, and like I said, today we're going to learn about different types of fruits. So if you don't have your Bibles on you at the moment, press pause, go run and grab them quickly. Okay, open your Bibles to Galatians 5. The Bible story today is going to be from verse 16 to 26, but I just want to read verse 22 with you guys. It says, but the fruit of the Spirit is love, joy, peace, patience, kindness, goodness, faithfulness, gentleness, and self-control. Against such things there is no law. Those who belong to Christ Jesus have crucified the sinful nature with its passions and desires. Since we live by the Spirit, let us keep in step with the Spirit. And so we're going to learn more about what the whole story is telling us. So let's watch our video.
Paul wrote a letter to the Christians in Galatia. Galatia was a province in Rome, and many of the Christians there were Gentiles, or non-Jews. Paul explained that God changes people who trust in Jesus. God gives them the Holy Spirit, who guides them and gives them power to become more like Jesus. Paul wrote that the Holy Spirit changes the way we think and act. He wanted believers to know that if you let the Holy Spirit guide you, you will do what God wants instead of what you want. When sin is in control, we do wrong things. We show hatred, jealousy, anger, selfishness, and greed. We fight and get into trouble. People who live like this will not enter God's kingdom. But Jesus frees us from the power of sin. His Holy Spirit lives in us and gives us power to do what is right. When the Holy Spirit is in control, people choose love, joy, peace, patience, kindness, goodness, faith, gentleness, and self-control. These actions are the fruit of the Spirit. Proof that the Spirit is in someone. Like how a healthy tree produces fruit. This fruit pleases God. Paul wrote that when we trust in Jesus, we no longer want to do whatever pleases ourselves. The Holy Spirit gives us power to say no to things like hatred, jealousy, anger, selfishness, and greed. The more we know Jesus, the more we will choose actions like joy, kindness, and self-control. We will want to live to please God. Since the Holy Spirit lives in us, we must let the Holy Spirit guide us. When we trust in Jesus, the Holy Spirit begins to change us. Paul told the believers in the Galatian church how to recognize that God is working in someone's life. People who are saved by Jesus become more like Him, and the Holy Spirit gives them power to say no to sin and to live in a way that pleases God.
So like I said today, we're going to learn about different kinds of fruits. For example, You see, God gives us a lot of natural examples to teach us about some of the things He does in our hearts and what happens spiritually. So He uses fruits as an example. In our lesson, we learned that we have fruits of the flesh. So those are selfish fruits, our sinful fruits, when we want to please ourselves. And we have fruits of the Spirit. And that's the fruits that God works in our hearts. And it gives us a desire to please God. And so if I plant an apple seed, and an apple, we would expect that an apple tree would grow. And off an apple tree, apples will grow. But if bananas start growing from the tree, I know that I didn't plant an apple seed. I planted a banana seed. And bananas will grow from banana seeds and banana trees. Likewise, God compares the gospel as a seed. And when we hear it and we believe it and we accept it, it is planted in our hearts and it grows. And the Holy Spirit works with the gospel to bear good fruits. It's important for us to know that it's not as good Christians, we're not good people when we do the good things, but rather that is the Holy Spirit who grows and bears these fruits. And when the Holy Spirit's working in our hearts, we desire to please God, not to please our own flesh or please our own sin, but rather to please and do the will of God. And so when the Holy Spirit was working in us, we start naturally growing these things and we start pleasing God with these things. And so we got to be trusting and praying after we receive the gospel that we continue to follow what God has for us. We continue to listen and pray and worship, and we continue to seek God so that we can please God in our hearts. And there's something in Psalms 1. So from Psalms 1 to 3, it says, blessed is the man who doesn't practice sin. He doesn't walk or practice the way that other people sin, but rather he seeks God's commandments. He seeks God's will and God's law for him, and he seeks God's word. So a man who rejects sin, seeks God's word for him, is like a tree that's planted next to a river that never runs dry, and he bears fruits in his seasons, and his leaves are always healthy. And that tells us about when we seek God, when we have the gospel planted in our hearts. Jesus says that He is the water that never, if for anyone who drinks from Jesus will never be thirsty again. It's like a river that never runs dry. And we'll always be full, and the Holy Spirit uses the gospel. He uses this water to bring good fruits in us, and our trees, our leaves never wither, regardless of the season, regardless if we're in summer when it's good seasons, or when we're in winter and it's cold and it's dry seasons, because we will be in good times and we will be in bad times. But we will know that regardless of what's happening around us, we can always trust God, and He will always keep us healthy, and our leaves will never wither. Our memory verse for this week comes from 2 Corinthians 5 verse 17, and it reads, "Therefore, if anyone is in Christ, he is a new creation. The old has passed away. Behold, the new has come." And this is what we get to learn in the fruits of the Spirit, is when we are in Christ, we stop bearing the fruits of our sinful desires and our flesh, and the Holy Spirit starts to bear the fruits of the Spirit. Love, joy, peace, patience. And it's not always an immediate thing. We can still sometimes fall into sin, but we know that when we continue to trust in God, He will bring these fruits out in us. We can always trust that these things that He has promised us, because of what Christ has done, we can hold on to. Thank you guys for joining us this week. Remember, you can go to our website, www.mpcc.org.za, to find more about this lesson and to go through at home. I'm excited that you guys are here, and we'll see you all next week. Bye for now.